Fresno, California. This Central Valley town is home to over 500,000 people and is one of the leading agricultural forces in the entire country. This agricultural town is slowly starting to become home for young Latino artists. Minutes away from Fresno is Madera, California. Here we met up with four artists that shared their experiences and what influences them as an artist.
Probably my family, my brother especially, because he was actually going for an art major, and I would see him every day just draw, and so he's older than me, and I would just try to mimic him. And yeah, that's what pretty much got me into it.
I've been interested in art for since when I was small. I still didn't even go to school or preschool, nothing. I see, like, my dad would bring books from, because he would travel to other cities to work. He would bring me books, like cutting books or something. And that would, like, kind of motivate me to, like, how did he get this, like, that? How is this possible?
Four artists have developed their own unique personal style, but have consistently collaborated to create pieces of art around Fresno.
The one we did at Arte America, yeah, it's 8x8, and so that one's pretty much the best one that I've been at.
What is it?
It's a mural. It's a Zapotec, and it has calligraphy in the background. It's based on a little deity from the Zapotec culture, and that's where we started. We started from there, and we were just improvising as we went along.
At the end of the day, my goal is to draw hyperrealism, and I'm trying to get. I look at it, I just want to I get this feeling where I want to draw it, and yeah, it goes from there.
Manuel and Gerardo focus on more vibrant pieces of art, where their colors almost make their art look surreal. While Edgar and Andres focus on a grittier, darker mood, influenced by some of pop culture's new icons.
I like the style, and I just like making my own. Imitate their style, but make them all.
This new wave of artists is bringing new ideas and fresh talent to the Central Valley. Their artwork is constantly changing the environments of their communities, and it looks like their artwork is here to stay.